In previous videos, I talked about ZFS raid pools. I will do a quick review of a ZFS Raid 1 for those that missed that video, and a reminder for those that did watch it. We said in a ZFS Raid 1, we would lose one disk space of storage, meaning if we have 3 2-gigabyte disks in our Raid 1, using 6 gigabytes of data, our Raid 1 would only have 4 gigabytes available for data. But if any single drive in that ZFS Raid 1 fails, our RAID 1 could continue until that disk could be replaced. We then talked about how data is stored on a ZFS RAID to handle a disk loss. And we learned that it is not data copied around to all the disks as we might think, but instead checksum information is available on the disks to recreate the data if one of those disks fails. The advantage to having checksum information on that disk is that when we read data from our ZFS RAID pool, ZFS compares that data to the checksum information for that data. And if that data read does not match the checksum, ZFS can correct that data before it passes that data on. So what would cause the data on that disk to go bad? The most common reason for data loss is bit rot. Bit rot happens when you have data sitting on a hard drive. Maybe you have a photo that you haven't looked at in years, and then you try and open it, and it doesn't show properly or doesn't open at all because some of the bits on that hard drive, where your photo is, have gone bad. With ZFS, when we open that picture with some bit rot, the data gets compared to those checksums and gets corrected, so our photo will open as expected. Data that gets accessed frequently gets compared to the checksums frequently. But what about the data that does not get accessed frequently? That is where a zpool scrub comes in. A scrub will compare all the data in the zpool against their checksums and repair any data that does not match up. I'm typing zpool list, and we see no zpools available. And I'll type lsblk to show what disks we have available. We see we've got the 5 2-gigabyte disks, SDB through SDF, available for ZFS. I'll create a ZFS RAID 1 zpool by pasting in the command sudo create my RAID 1 RAID Z on the disks SDB, SDC, and SDD. And let's check the zpool status. And everything looks good. I'm going to clear the screen. I want to force a zpool scrub right now. To do that, I'll type in sudo zpool scrub, and then the name of the zpool that I want to scrub, which in this case is my RAID 1. And we can check the status with zpool status. Our scrub completed and repaired 0 bytes of data. And since the zpool is so small, only 6 gigabytes, it finished pretty quick in 1 second. To see what it looks like running, I will append on the zpool status to our scrub command. And that's what it looks like when it's running. Bringing up the zpool status again shows that it completed with no errors. Here's a picture of a zpool status showing some disk errors. We see here that our middle disk shows a faulted with too many errors. Under our status, we see that one or more disks are faulted, and that sufficient replicas exist for our zpool to continue functioning in a degraded state. Then the suggested action is to replace the faulted drive or use zpool clear to mark the device as repaired. So ZFS doesn't tell us we need to replace that disk, but it does warn us that we might want to replace that disk. If you see a message like this and you have important data on that disk, and that disk is 5 or more years old, you should probably swap out that disk in question for a new one. Now, I want to point out that scrubs can be resource intensive. You probably want to schedule the scrub to run at night or during low activity hours. If you started a scrub that will run a long time, then you realize that you're about to go into a busy part of the day, you can stop that scrub by adding -s to the scrub. Sudo zpool scrub -s, and then the zpool name. It is suggested that we run a scrub at least once a month or more, depending upon how you feel about your data and how long that scrub takes to run on your machine. ZFS does have some default crons that run. They can be found in etc cron d zfsutils -linux. Let's less into that file with sudo less etc cron.d zfsutils -linux. We see on the first Sunday of every month, ZFS will perform the trim command. The trim command will look for all the free space in a zpool and reclaim that free space. Then on the second Sunday of the month, a scrub is run. Another thing I should mention is that ZFS does like to use memory, so the more memory you have, the better. I have heard people say that if you don't have a lot of memory, it doesn't matter, it will just take longer to run. Well, if you only have a couple of gig in your zpool, you can probably get away with a small amount of memory. But if you're using terabytes of data, you will probably want to have as much memory as possible. If you only have 4 or 6 gig of memory and you want to work with terabytes of data, you may want to consider using LVM instead of ZFS. LVM can get by with a lot less memory than ZFS, but you do lose out on that data integrity that you get with ZFS. Now, you may have heard that you need to use ECC memory with ZFS. ECC stands for error correction code. Yes, it's better to use error correction code memory if you have it, but it's not required for ZFS. Wrapping up this video also wraps up this group of videos looking at ZFS. In the next tutorial, we'll continue looking at the Linux command line.